Hi, my name is Prenita Dutt. Welcome to my life page. Today we'll be talking about teaching art to adults with disabilities. And before we do that, I'd like to give a little introduction about myself. I did my schooling from Dehradun and I did my college from Delhi. My education is in counseling and psychology. And I've been a professional artist for the last 12 years. So the whole process of creating something on a surface is what we would call art. But there are many who don't feel any need for it, or they might not really understand why they are doing a certain thing. But we cannot assume anything. Our job as an art teacher is to introduce everything in a friendly way, in a simplified manner, and so that they are able to create something on that surface. One of the most important ones would be psychology, because in psychology you learn about child psychology, developmental psychology, abnormal psychology, and through all these subjects, statistics and all, you understand a lot more about human nature than you otherwise would. One of the most important would be patience, to be able to understand what is the requirement of the person specifically who you're dealing with, and to be able to put some of your energy into their work. I think, as you might understand, it is satisfaction, the kind of joy you get when working outside your own comfort zone and with a group of people who have such a different energy and such a beautiful level of acceptance. It's a different experience. It could be a wide variety of people that you have in a certain group, and it is not a homogeneous group. It is a group with the range is incredible. The kind of issues that people are dealing with is also very vast. So the knowledge that one needs to have, and then the creativity one needs to have in order to put art forward in a way that they consume with delight and not fear, is the biggest challenge. It would typically start with one deciding about the activity that is to be done on that day, and which means that you need to have all your resources together, you need to have your materials together, you need to know how you're going to dispense with those materials, and how to handle the group, and what could be the possible fallouts of a certain activity. It could be that the group is just not interested in it and they want to do something different. Then do you have a backup plan? It could also mean that you run short of some material which you never really thought about earlier. And then do you have other things to produce at last minute notice, which happens very often. And so it would mean that you plan your activity and then you execute the activity with the group, and then you conclude the activity with the group again. It's like a debrief when you ask them how they felt about it, were the areas which were difficult for them, if so, would they like to talk about it, and if yes, then you discuss that. It could also mean, would they be comfortable enough to share their artwork with the rest of the group? There are always some members who are very happy to share what they've done. And then they like to talk about what they enjoyed about it, what they felt about the colors. Sometimes they even have opinions about what I was not able to convey to them, and they are very comfortable expressing that. So whenever they share something, the group applauds their effort. They turn their art file around and they show what they've done. And seeing them, the shyer members, somebody who's not used to really being in the focus, would also want to show, and that's a very good skill for them to know that I am appreciated, I've done something that is applaudable. I hope I've been able to give you enough information about teaching art to a group of people with disabilities. and that this life page has been of some use to you. I do hope that you're able to carry your own passion for art and psychology and working with people with disabilities to a new level. Thank you so much for listening.